I called my dad over and said, "Dad, I found a fossil." He reluctantly made his way towards me because he knew what I had found already. I had found an antelope fossil, because that's all you ever find. Just to put it into perspective, at the time, for every hominid fragment we found, we'd find roughly 250,000 antelope fossils. So he knew what I had found, but he wanted to encourage fossil hunting in his 9-year-old son. So he made his way over, and about 5 meters away, he stopped dead in his tracks and started swearing. I thought he was swearing at me, so I kind of looked shocked and said, "Well, what did I do wrong?" And he said, "Nothing, nothing, you found a hominid fossil." The piece I was holding was the clavicle, which is the collarbone, and he knew this because at the time he was probably one of the only world's experts on the hominid clavicle, because he had done his PhD on the shoulder region of hominids. So he could identify the S-shaped clavicle right away to be that of a primate. He came over and we started looking at the rock, and as we were looking at it and turning it to get a better angle, we noticed on the backside of this rock was a hominid mandible sticking out. This is when we knew we had something very special, and we started celebrating, called to get a permit to take this fossil off the site because it was at the Cradle of Humankind, which is a UNESCO World Heritage Site. And then about 2 weeks later, my dad returned with his team to uncover even more fossils at this site, which led to one of the largest hominid discoveries in history. When I first made the initial discovery, I didn't really understand the importance and significance of it because I was 9 years old at the time and hadn't really been around any of these discoveries. I knew that's what my dad was looking for, but didn't really know why or the reason to it. We released the fossil about 2 years after the initial discovery to the public because we had to make sure we got all the science correct and identified all the bones properly and all of that. And the find and discovery turned into actually a new species of hominid, Australopithecus sediba, and turned into multiple individuals and multiple skeletons. After the 2 years, I think that was when I kind of realized the importance and significance, because I obviously had to keep it a secret for these 2 years, but it wasn't that hard because I didn't really know what to boast or brag about to my friends. So it was pretty easy to keep it a secret. But when we released it to the public, we did it at a press conference out in Maripeng. And that's when it actually hit me that, wow, this is important. Because I remember walking into that press conference room and there being about 100 different camera crew and journalists and TV presenters, all there to hear about what we had discovered. Once you actually realize what a discovery like that can do for the world, for the area of study such as paleoanthropology and for exploration in general, it's really quite impressive to be a part of, and very privileged to have been a part of something like that. It's very cool to see how many doors have opened since that discovery, because in the early 2000s it was actually thought that the world of paleoanthropology in Africa was